Welcome to the statics tutorials. So for this problem, we have a rigid body that's supported on this end with a smooth, frictionless pin connection at A, and then it's connected to a weightless link here, B to C. Because the weightless link is weightless, and the B and C are both frictionless pins, this member here can only support either a tension or a compression. And then we have a distributed load that's 20 kilonewton per meter. It's triangular. The peak of the triangle is 1 meter over from A and 1.5 meters over from B. And then we have the height here from B to C. So I need to solve for the reactions at A and B. So let's draw our free body diagram. So for our pin at A, we have an AX and an AY. We have our distributed load, the 20 kilonewton per meter. And then just calculating the hypotenuse of the distance triangle here, the 2.5 meters by the 2 meters, we find that that's 3.202. And so we draw that triangle here on TBC. I drew TBC as if it was in tension, as if it was pulling on the end at B. And we'll just see if we get a positive number. If we do, then it's in tension. If we get a negative number, then it's in compression. So let's do our sum of forces in the x direction. We have AX minus, because the x component of TBC is going in this negative x direction, TBC times the x component here of the triangle divided by the hypotenuse here of the triangle. So 2.5 divided by the 3.202 is equal to 0. So AX is 0.7809 times TBC. Then we can do our sum of forces in the y equation. So we have AY, and then with this triangle, because it's not an isosceles triangle, we're gonna eventually have to break it up into two right triangles. So I just went ahead and broke it up and showed it as the two right triangles here and the sum of forces of the y equation. For the sum of forces, you could have done it as just one large triangle that would have worked and then broken it up here. Either way would be fine. But the two individual smaller right triangles, 1/2 the 20 kilonewtons times the 1 meter here, and then 1/2 the 20 kilonewton per meter times the 1.5 meters over here. And then we have minus TBC times the y side here divided by the hypotenuse. So the 2 divided by the 3.202. TBC, y component is negative, so we have a negative sign here. Distributed load is negative, so we have the two negative signs there. We get this equation after some simplification, but we still can't solve it yet because we have two unknowns, and then we need to do some of the moments. We could do some of the moments either about A to eliminate AX and AY, or we could do some of the moments here about B to eliminate AX since it goes through point B and TBC. I just chose some of the moments about A. Here are our distributed loads. Remember, with the distributed load, you have the distance portion. So this is your distance portion, 2/3 times 1 meter to get here to this centroid location for the first distributed load. And then we have to multiply that by the force. So the force is going to be this 1/2 distributed load times the base of the distributed load. Here's our, and this distributed load gives us a negative moment about A. Here's our next distributed load. So we've got our force portion here, and then we have our distance portion here to our centroid. For this centroid, it's a little bit trickier. We have to go over the 1 meter, and then we have to go over then another third of that distance. So 1/3 of the 1.5, the base for the second distributed load. And then there's the force part. And then for our TBC, we just need our y component. So we can grab our y component out of sum of forces in the y. So 2 over 3.202 times TBC. And then multiply that by this x distance back over to A. The x component of TBC has a line of action that goes through A, and so it wouldn't contribute a moment. From here, we just have the one unknown, so we can solve it. We get negative 18.7 kilonewtons. So that means that that direction should be opposite, so it's really in compression instead of tension. So I wrote 18.7 kilonewtons and then a little C out next to it to show that it's in compression. Make sure that you do the tension and compression only with these two force members, so things like trusses and weightless links and things like that. And then for AY, we plug our value for TBC in here. We get our value for AY, plug our value for TBC in here, and we get our AX. We get an AX that's negative, and so that means our AX is directed over in this direction to counteract the compressive force that TBC exerts on point B. Thanks for watching.